Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to show you how to go from this image with just the front element in focus and this picture back here out of focus, this flower back here out of focus, and the second image with just the one behind in focus and the ones in front out of focus. You're gonna go from those two images to this image where you have everything in focus and you're not shooting at a ridiculously high f-stop, which will cause some refraction and, you know, reduce the sharpness of your image. And this process is focus stacking, and the Nikon Z6 has included an automatic focus shift which allows you to do this almost pretty much entirely automatically, and that is just a great time saver. I'm sure people who have done it in the past can attest to the fact that this was a very strenuous activity, and today within a few clicks we can move from, you know, this image to this image and this image to that image. And this final image is actually a compilation of 15 images that have been automatically stacked. So I'm going to show you how I went about this. And also, you can see this image right here. This is a good image that can be used because most of the flower is in focus, and the flower is actually the main thing in this image. But for my purposes, this glass piece here really excites me, and I want to see it in focus, because when it's in focus, it actually helps bring out the flowers a lot more, because there's light refraction that goes on and it just looks good. So what did I do? I took a series of images and I focus stacked them and made sure that all of it was in focus. So I went from this image to this image. This image right here, let's look at the corners. Glass is not sharp. These petals are not sharp, okay? But the middle is nice and sharp. We went from this image right here to this image where everything is sharp. Glass is sharp and all these guys are still sharp. It was 10 images that were automatically combined in Photoshop. All right, so let's dive right in. All right, so this is my setup outside. I put a whiteboard and I use this glass cone, which is actually about 6 inches long. And I have one flower right inside the cone, and I've laid the other ones in front of it too. So there's quite a distance between them. But the angle from which I'm shooting, it looks like they're not that far apart. So from this angle, I'm going to demonstrate the focus stacking, because I want everything to be in focus, and because it's very close to the camera, this is going to be a challenge. I'm using the Nikon 28-300 lens. It's not a macro lens, it's just a kit lens. All right, in your camera, you go to menu and then you go to the photo shooting mode. And then when you go to the photo shooting mode, the focus shift shooting is actually the last but one. So the last one, it's a silent photography. And when you go up one step, it's right there. And then you hit OK. So when you hit OK, you come down and then you see the number of shots. The number of shots, it depends on how deep the focus is, like how much do you want to cover. And I have determined that anything around a foot, you need about 20 pictures to cover a foot. So you can do the calculation from there. So the focus step width also depends on what f-stop you are shooting at. If you are shooting at a very shallow depth of field, f2.8, you want to have a very tiny focus step width. It starts from 1 to 10. So I was shooting at f8, so I just figured the 8 will be good, and it was actually good, because you want the sharpness to overlap. Okay, for the interval, I just keep it at 1 second, because I don't want to overwhelm the camera and try to make it do it all at once. And so that's what I do for the interval. And then first frame exposure lock, I don't fully understand it, but I leave it on because it works when it's on. And and then you hit start, and then you just wait, it goes preparing, and then it starts doing its thing within a few seconds, and it just goes click, 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 until it's done taking the number of pictures that you have assigned it to do. So always remember that it starts from the front and goes backwards. So one trick I have been using is that I focus, if this is the very front of the image of the object, focus a little bit in front of that object so that it starts from out of focus, then it goes to get the object and it goes beyond the object as well. So this could mean some try and error, and then you have to increase your number of shots and probably reduce the focus step width, because that's how much it shifts the focus. So you want the sharpness to definitely overlap each other. All right, and that's it. So from here, we go straight to Lightroom and then Photoshop real quick. All right. So there are 15 images, but I'm going to edit one, and I'm going to apply the same setting to all the other images. Here's what's gonna happen. Because I didn't move the tripod, it should work perfectly for all the other images. I noticed that the bottom part of the image is a little bit dark, so I'm going to use this graduated filter to come up just a little bit, like right there, because these sides are too bright. And I'm gonna go and just give it a little bit more exposure. There we go. And I'm going to take the vignette down, because the vignette is killing the white flowers. So I'm gonna go all the way down here. Where's my vignette? Okay, I'm gonna bring the vignette up a little bit. All right, that's good. Are we blowing out? Okay, it's the same spot. That's fine. I'm kind of okay with this. So what I'm going to do is, once this image is selected, I'm going to hold down shift and I'm going to go all the way to the last image and go to sync, and make sure you sync the crop. So we got to find where the crop is right here and then sync the crop. So it's going to do all the crop stuff that I did, local adjustments. That too, because I had done a graduated filter thing, so it's gonna do all that. I'm going to synchronize now. So now it's cropped them all the same. You want the crop to be the same. It's easier for Photoshop to merge and not go crazy. Okay, so this is what I did for the first actuation of this thing, for the first round of my focus stacking. So this is the first image. I'm going to walk you through the rest of the images. So this is the first image. You see the focus is all the way up front. This is the second image, third, fourth. You see green is losing focus. See that? The green is losing focus right there. All right. Fifth. Now all of a sudden the focus is somewhere here. It's somewhere around the second ring of this crystal. Seven. Our body here is almost getting in focus. Eight. Now it looks like he is pretty much, not quite, but in focus. The focus is just in front of him, about two rings away in front of him. Eight. Nine. Okay, now the body back here is I think he's in focus now at nine, at eight. Yeah, he is in focus now. So at this point you can see that all the flowers in front are not in focus, they're completely out of focus, but that guy back there is in focus, and he is, you know, 6 inches away from the rest of the crew. And it took quite a few shots to get there. So 8 and then 9, 10. good. 10 is now, he's now slightly out of focus. So I'm going to go with 9. There. So this is good. This, yeah, at this point he's out of focus, the little green guy back here, and there's nothing behind it that I want to use that I can actually see. So I don't need that last picture. But apart from that last picture, I need all the other pictures for the focus stacking. Okay, so at this point we're going to move everything over to Photoshop and quickly do everything. So I'm going to go with, now that I've selected all the images that I need to do my focus stacking, I'm going to go to photo and I'm going to go to edit in, don't click the first one, go to open as layers in Photoshop. So what happens is that this is going to open each individual image as a layer so that you can selectively use certain parts of the image to make your final product. All the images are now in Photoshop and it's time to align. The first thing you want to do is you want to align the layers before you blend it so that you know, Photoshop will know exactly where to blend what, because it can tell which part of the image is sharp and which part is not sharp. So here we go. First thing we do is we go to edit and then we look for auto align. Oops, we have to select all the images before it's gonna work. So you click one here and you hit shift and you click the last one and that should select all of them, and then you go to edit, auto align layers, there, and you just leave it on auto, especially since I use the tripod, there shouldn't be much of a change at all. So okay, and here we go. All right, so the layers are aligned and looks like we are ready to rumble. Are you ready to rumble? All right, so looks like we are ready to. So the next thing we do here is we go back to edit and then we go to auto blend. So this auto blend is very smart. Stack, make sure it's on stack images. Okay, it's just, all it's going to do is it's going to find the sharp portions of the image and let those through, and then let only the sharp portions of each image through, but it will keep a background of blurriness, whatever, but it's kind of smart. So we'll see what we get. Ha, and hello dear friends, we have a picture that has the first flower in focus and the last one in focus. Watch this. We're about to zoom in here. Okay, now I have to hit my Z. Watch this, you see that? The first flower is in focus and the last flower is in focus. With a little creativity, there's a lot that you can do with this. So we have a picture that has this flower in focus, has the whole crystal in focus, and then has the very last flower back there also in focus. Voila! So now I'm just going to collapse all the layers. Control shift E. People say don't do that, but you gotta do it. And then I'm just going to save. And then I'm going to, once you save it and you close it, it takes the image back to Lightroom. That same image takes it back to Lightroom. So just, that's how they work these days. Somehow the last image I clicked on was 35. So it puts the image that just came from Photoshop behind it. So just have that in mind when you are working on stuff. Okay, so here we have our image in Lightroom, and there's not much I want to do next other than export it, and then voila. Now Now that it's back in Lightroom, you can apply any edits you want to it and stuff.